Okay, so there is this coreboot stuff, but who really do does? Like, who cares about this project? So there are many companies that are involved, some of them very, very serious, like Google, Siemens, AMD, Intel, MediaTek. We can also find some cool information about Open Compute Project, with kind of which is place where Facebook and Google and right now many other organizations try to create open server, which gives well-maintained firmware, well-maintained hardware for a long time. You can see even that official Tesla GitHub account contain coreboot fork, which means maybe they're using it for some reasons. There are situations where some coreboot licensed service providers are hired by some customers. In, for example, in case of port of Supermicro, one company was hired by VPN provider. It's very interesting that, for example, VPN providers see the value in open source firmware. So why coreboot? It's free. It's free as free beer. It's very simple design. It does minimum booting to minimum what is needed to boot OS. It's vendor independent. It's cross platform. It's very fast. It's way easier than UEFI. In comparison to legacy BIOS written in assembly, the code quality is much better. It's much more flexible. It's very important because many companies want to customize firmware in ways that it will work in special way on their hardware. And typically, this is not supported by BIOS or UEFI vendors. Of course, you may pay them like big buck, but also you can go to open source firmware and take open source firmware, modify, optimize performance, like do some more power saving, add security, disable some features. For example, there was a story from Siemens that they had CNC machine that they wanted to disable SMIs, and it was impossible in UEFI, and because those SMIs cause some delays in CNC machines, what make it less precise. And coreboot is cross-platform. It's not only possible to run on one machine; many machines can be run. It's easy to port relatively. If you will go through training, definitely you can understand how to do that. And we recently see even more commitment. So you can see that Purism, laptop producer, like secure laptop producer, System76, another provider of laptops, loves open source firmware and coreboot. We also see companies like Insurgo, which provide CubesOS certified laptops. Look at coreboot as valuable boot system, and also firewall providers like Protectly, PC Engines. Those companies see value, and their customers see value in coreboot as a BIOS for those hardware. If that is not enough, there is even government commitment. So, for example, there is Federal Office for Information Security in Germany. It's good example, and like representants of this agency frequently attended coreboot conference on open source firmware conference, saying that they value coreboot because they can fork it. It's secure. They are not depending on anyone. It's easy to audit. They can check the code that runs on government administration machines. And that is very, very important for them. There is even an NSA contribution to coreboot. Very interesting contribution about SMI transfer monitor for Intel. Interestingly, there are some presentation where person who ported STM said that someone asked what is needed to support SMI transfer monitor, which is advanced security feature of Intel platforms. He say you need STM friendly BIOS. So coreboot is definitely STM friendly BIOS. not UEFI implementations, not some old BIOS implementations.